first coffee, real life begins after coffee. Today I have my third video for you in my fall series. If you missed the other two, they will be linked down in the down bar. And in case you missed it, along with my fall series, I'm giving away an Urban Decay Naked palette of your choice. All the info for that will be in the down bar. Today for the fall series, I thought that I would go into the nail polish department and share with you three fun nail art designs. All three of these designs feature stripers, which are these handy little things. I never purchased these. If you guys have been around Butt First Coffee for a little while, you know that I have shared a handful of nail art tutorials that require no nail art tools. And I will link some of those in the down bar if you want to check them out. But I finally sort of just caved and thought I would buy some stripers because there's lots of different designs you can't do without a striper. And I picked up this black one from NYC. It was $1.99, not really breaking the bank. And then I picked up a Sally Hansen I Heart Nail Art one. This one was $4. But that's about it. Let's just jump right into the three tutorials. And all the information for the giveaway will be at the end of the video, so I'll see you there. This first design is these cute autumn colored stripes. Start by taking a few different fall colors and apply them to your nails vertically in a random order. I chose to do four different colors. The colors I chose was Essie's Sheerly Darling, Revlon's Craving Coral, Revlon's Jaded Night, and Revlon's Cool Beige, and I have them randomly placed across my nails. After that, come in with the black striper and simply draw in a thin black line between each color. Use a top coat to seal this and it's done. This one is super simple and I love it because I think it looks a lot more involved and tricky than it actually was. Design 2 is this plaid. Everyone loves a good flannel in the fall, so I thought this one was perfect. I started with a gray-brown base, but you can take pretty much any color you want, and then take a lighter shade and draw a horizontal line across the top one-third of the nail. Don't worry about it being too perfect. After giving that a chance to dry, I came in with the black striper and I'm drawing a line on each side of the light color and then one down the center. It's easiest to place the striper on the nail and then slightly roll your finger as you pull the striper across. If you've never used one of these before, just do a few test lines before you go to create your look. Lastly, I came in with the red, taking it vertical on the opposite side and horizontal along the bottom. I waited for all to dry and then finished it with a top coat. This is the last design and it definitely requires a more steady hand than the other two, but like I said, just practice a few times and I swear it gets really easy. I've used Revlon's Cool Beige on my nails, and now I'm taking a white polish halfway down my nail on one side. Then I'm going about a quarter of the way down on the other side. Using the black striper, I'm lining the white, slightly overshooting each line because I'm going to use this to connect them together. Then I'm going to go in and connect the two lines into a loop. When it's completely dry, I finish it all with a top coat. All right, guys, that was all three of the nail art designs. For your entry to win an Urban Decay Naked palette of your choice, leave me a comment in the down bar telling me which of the three nail arts were your favorite. You know what I mean? Was it one, two, or three? Which one did you like the most? Which one are you most likely to recreate? And if you didn't like any of them, just make it up because I don't want you to hurt my feelings. No, I'm kidding. If you didn't like one, you can say that none of them were really for me, but I still want to enter to win the Urban Decay Naked palette. That'll totally be accepted as an entry. You won't hurt my feelings. Not everybody's gonna like everything. we're all different, you know what I'm saying? But that does it for today's video. Thank you so, so much for taking the time to stop by and to watch. I hope you're all having a fantastic day, and I will see you all in my next video.